we're gonna take out Gemini. He's new to pack walking. He's been on one pack walk before, and he's met everyone here except one dog. So we'll show you that introduction. Because it's really important that you, for me, it's really important that I introduce dogs in a certain way, and I'll show you as we go, so you have something interesting to look at. So first I'm going to take out Gemini. He's going to try to bust out. I didn't want him to jump out because he's so short and it's bad for their back to do that. And he has an injury. You can get him in it. Okay, cool. So now we're going to go to this side because Badger's on this side. So a little bit about Gemini is he's been doing some daycare. Mostly working on, well, the crate. So he's really stressed about the crate, like his wide panting and his tongue out. That's all crate stress. His social, he's pretty reactive. Well, now not anymore, but when he first started, he was really reactive. So like really on a high alert whenever he would even smell dogs around. Another thing, he's just trying to like get his anxiety out, but I want him to just like relax, not get more worked up. That's why I'm not letting him like scratch a lot or chew himself or anything. He's just really anxious about the crate. So in here is some dogs, and I just want Badger. So a little about Badger is he's been walking, hiking with us for a really long time, and before that, his parents did a lot of training, and so anyway, I know Badger really well. He might try to jump out, which I'm not gonna allow. Wait, no, no. Tinkerbell, no. Okay, they're all crowding the door. No. Wait. Wait. My water bottle is leaking everywhere. This is Badger. Wait. Okay, I had to get a leash. So, Badger's on a martingale and a remote. For this, I'm just using the leash, really. The remote's just for off-leash. Okay. Wait. Are you ready? Wait. So, Badger usually jumps out a lot, but he has, like, a back injury, so I'm actually going to lure him out. Badger. Good. No. And now, intro? Yeah. Yeah. Badger knows me really well, so he knows not to mess with Gemini very much. Gemini's taking some space. He's over there. So, I'm gonna, unload the rest of the van, and so you can watch more of the body language, and especially particularly Gemini. And everyone else here, like I said, he already met them last week. No. Peppa. Good. So every time I let a dog out, I kind of do a little vibe check. But get them to stop messing with each other too much, I'll say their name or I'll use the leash. Hey, chill. So Tink has a back injury too, or arthritis or something. I'm gonna step on the leashes so they can't get away. Tinkerbell. Good. My van is really low, but compared to like a truck, but it's still gotta still be careful with those backs and stuff. Good, Gem. Okay, Herbie, you need a leash. Okay, I had to get another leash for Herbie. Herb. So you can see, I want everyone to come out by their name. That was because he was trying to walk away and drag on the leash, so I said, I've got one more dog to take out. Peanut. Good. So, Gemini's hanging out on the edges, like he's not in here messing with anyone, which is really good. And his tail will tell you exactly how he's feeling. I guess right now he's a little either comfortable or aloof. I don't know. I said his tail would tell you exactly what he's feeling, but I don't know what he's feeling right now. Okay, I'm gonna put everyone on remotes, pretty much. Not Gem, he's not trained on it. You already have one on. Hey. Good, Herbie. This will take just a minute, and then we'll walk into the park. All right. Good. Gemini, no. Come here. Part of being a dog walker is your leashes are tangled all the time. But it really is worth it to take the 10 seconds, Peanut, to fix them. Because you can communicate with each dog individually a lot easier that way. If they're all tangled, then it's just a mess. Okay. Good. Okay, so now I'm walking in. I'm locking my car. On everyone. Slack is different than short. Hey, Herbie. I usually do short and slack. That's my goal. So short is the length of the leash, and slack means that there's no tension on the leash. A lot of times people just make it short and tight, which is not good. I want them walking in with me nice. This is nice. Pretty much aloof. They're all kind of not really paying attention to each other. And they all have their own little things. Like, I know Peanut really wants to go pee really bad. Gemini's tail is right up, maybe because we're heading to a new place. Oh, pause it. He's pooping. So I'm going to pick up this poop tank. I don't like when they put tension on the leash and try to get somewhere, so that's what they both did with him, to sniff him. They made the leash tight, so I told them, by their name, I told them to stop it. Hold on. Good, fat. Hey. I'm not making Gemini walk in like a nice formation. He gets a little leeway for now. Right in and cut to the right really quick. Oh, hi. Okay, they're walking. Good. I always want them to go in the poles with me, like right there, because it's annoying. it's annoying when they try to go on the other side of the pole. Hey, bud. Badger, go potty. We're gonna go off leash, but not right this second. You can maybe do a quick shot at that. Okay, so as you can see, I'm all tangled again. Classic. Classic dog walker syndrome. Peppa, come on, please. They're screaming, they're carrying a stick, so we're gonna just wait over here. So these guys are really used to this routine. Badger, no.
Sit. I know, look, it's a little puppy.
Yeah.
He's eating all the puppies.
What's Gemini doing? He was eating grass. I think he's a little stressed out. So, I walked in a big loop to not get tangled up again. Oh, everyone needs to poop. My shoelace is untied. I can't give Peanut more leash because I'm all tangled. These are all the little details that add up that make your job harder or easier. Tink. Like, if these dogs all pulled on the leash whenever, that would make my job a lot harder. So I always focus on that detail. Sorry, this is she hut out or is it gross? Hi.
How's it going?
Good. Good. So like if they were all trying to get somewhere and I need to pick up this poop, that's really hard. But since they're all on a nice slack leash, then I'm not being yanked around. Or worse, what happens is people get, like they want to just let the dogs off because that's easier than being yanked around. I don't like that, because all these guys have some kind of history of why they're with me special, or my company, my other walkers, who I work with, special, they're special with us, so they have some kind of special reason why they walk with SCRUF. We just keep running into stuff. Baby in a stroller with a dog. Peppa? No. No. We're gonna try to hang a right. Hopefully there's nobody over in this field. These leashes, they're like 6 feet, 8 feet, 10 feet long, and they, so I can let the leash out up to a good amount, so like they can have some space. I'm waiting to let them off because there's a baby and a dog and a stroller walking by. It's taking a long time. leashes except for Jem. I told them to wait because I don't want them just running around just as soon as their leash drops. That's not the cue. The cue is I get to tell them, take a break. The cue isn't your leash drop. So, Badger, come. Good. So that's that. We'll check in later with Badger and Gemini, but right now they seem totally fine. Alright, we're gonna do a water break. I noticed Badger has been kind of like really low-key guarding the water bowl, so I'm gonna make him do something special. Hey, Badger, come. Badger, no. Lay down. Good. So it's been like, no, lay down. It's been really low-key guarding, but I noticed the other dogs don't really drink, so I'm making kind of a, being strict about it, because the other dogs are smarter than me when it comes to the other dogs, each other, if that makes sense. I don't think he's ever really done it. I think I've seen him do a lip curl one time, but that was a long time ago. Water time is a really big problem in a lot of people's packs. They've got all the dogs jumping around, spinning in circles, trying to all get the water at the same time, which, as you can see by this group, is not something that we allow. Herbie, no, come. Good. Wait. Because it's too chaotic. And some of the dogs we walk are very, either very sensitive, so they won't drink if they think another dog is trying to get it, so then they don't drink, which is, like, fine, they can drink at home, Furby. Or, Peanut. Or they are very, or they fight over the water. So yeah, some big fights happen around the water bowl, or have happened, or like that's a common place, because it's one of the only resources that we use in our packs that they could guard. Like, we don't really throw the ball much, a little bit, or sticks, or stuff like that, so there's not a whole lot of resources they could fight over, except the water. You can have a drink. Alright. Just an update, so Badger and Gemini have been fine. I have Tinkerbell on leash just because she's been lagging, probably from her arthritis or just her sniffing. Yeah, nothing really. Gemini's thing that I've seen him do with other dogs when they're too much like in his space by his standards is he'll get like really like snarly and loud. And when he's done that, I told him, no, he's not allowed to do that. And I haven't seen him do it on any of these hikes. Yeah, he seems kind of like worried, but pretty much happy guy. Worried, yeah, I don't know what he's worried about. Who knows? But he hasn't seemed worried about the other dogs much. Like, he's letting them sniff him, and he's sniffing them and stuff like that. Huh. That's it. Good integration. Check. Oh, don't forget to subscribe to the channel.